Hello friends, in this video we will learn how to use SimulIed. Okay, we will learn use of SimulIed. Okay, so now open your SimulIed platform. How to open? I think you had already downloaded all those required software which I had given to you, and you have already extracted and installed on your system. As I mentioned in the previous video, so come to the SimulIed, come to the bin, and double click into the SimulIed exe. Okay, now come here. First we will learn only utilization of SimulIed. So here you will find the component. Okay, this one is the component here. This, now you can see this one is the component. Okay, after that this is RAM type. Okay, now there is the property, sorry, this is the component. Okay, then if you will click, so it is RAM type, you will find property and file explorer. Okay, so how we can select the property, I will show you. For that, now first of all come into the probe. Okay, or first of all come into the here fixed voltage. What is the fixed voltage? Okay, now take this one is the fixed voltage, drag and drop, click drag and drop, it is 5 volt. Okay, it is a 5 volt. Okay, now you can see it is a 5 volt. Okay, so how can we, so if you will click here, okay, on off. Okay, it's on, it's off. Okay, now come to the property. Now by if you will select any object, then property will appear. Okay, now you can see the speed is 1 mega. The okay, so it is automatically scalable. True and false there is, and there is AC current is 5 volts. So can we change this one? Let's change. Okay, so it is fixed 5 volt. Okay, if you want to change, can we change? No, it is fixed 5 volt. Okay, now if you come to the component, now come to the voltmeter. If you drag it, drag the voltmeter and connect. Now connect again. It is a voltmeter. Drag the voltmeter and connect. Okay, now after that run. Okay, okay, why it's not working? Because ground has not given. So let's check a, let's take a ground and connect the ground. Let's try to check. Run. So it is 5 volt. Okay, so it is a 5 volt. So now you can write your first program and you can check your SimulIed. So again, let's stop, select all and delete. We can delete. No, can we select like this? Okay, can we delete? Yes, we can delete. Again, let's take one more variable voltage source. This is our variable. This is my variable voltage source. I can move this voltage source from like this. Okay, so let's come into the property here. Okay, variable voltage source, but it's a 5 volt maximum. Okay, now come into the component. Okay, come into the component and come here, the volt oscilloscope or voltage. First take the voltmeter, take voltmeter. Now come into the ground, take ground and connect like this, click and click. Now click here and click like this. Now run. So it is 1.5. now decrease, increase. Okay, good. If I will take one oscilloscope, if I will take one oscilloscope here, and if I will connect the oscilloscope, click like this. Okay, now run. So is giving anything? No. Stop, come to the ground. and run. So can we see, we cannot see value here, just because here oscilloscope cannot show your DC power. Okay, it cannot show your DC fixed power. Okay, so for that, how can we show, how can we show the result? For that, first stop our simulation, click on this one, delete, click this one, sorry, delete. Now look at here, their probe is present. Now come into the probe, place the probe, right click in the probe, add to plotter, right click in the probe and add to plotter. So now you can see the plotter for zero. Okay, plotter. So now the color is, again, if you will take one more plotter, okay, let's connect with the this, no, take this here, run. So now you can see the voltage is 2.1 volt. If I increase, then it will be increase more. If I will increase, it will increase more here, like ramp. If I will decrease, so it will be decrease again. So now you can see in the probe, and you can also see the value here, 1.83 volt. Okay, it's generating 1.3 volts, is, and now you can see on the voltmeter 1.8. okay, 1.83 1.8. okay, so you can write your code, you can take the component from the SimulIed and you can paste here like this. Now take this one and delete again. Now come here and take a waveform generator. Now this one is our waveform generator. Okay, this one is our waveform generator. Now click here and come to the property. You will find here the waveform type. The waveform type is sine waveform. Can we change this one? Okay, yes, we can change. We can change sawtooth, triangular and square. Okay, or, and can we change the voltage? Yes, we can change the voltage also here. Okay, we can change the voltage also from this platform. Okay, we can change the voltage from this platform also. Okay, if you will click, then you can change the voltage. So now come into the component and right click, and where is the oscilloscope? There is the oscilloscope. Take this one, let's drag it and let's check. Okay, now could we need a ground? Let's check first. Now run. So it's showing up, it's showing us the sine waveform with the 5 volt. Okay, okay, sine waveform with 5 volt. If we'll change the property, if we'll change the property of this sine waveform, sorry, property types of type of waveform, then sawtooth, so it will show sawtooth. If we will change, it is completely free. You can use this software for your circuit design, and you can use this software for your network analysis kind of the subject. Now click here and triangular. So now if you want to change the value, so you can give the value 1 volt also. Okay, so here is the 1 volt, so maximum is the 1 volt. Okay, now come into the component, right click, come to the probe, take the probe here and connect. Okay, take the probe here and connect. Okay, and run. Okay, now right click, add plotter. So now you can see the, I think probe is not connected properly. Take and connect probe here. Run. Let's see what value probe will show. Okay, probe is not working. Why? Let's check. Delete this one. Now connect this one with the probe. Okay, now both are connected. Now run. Okay, so let's come here and change the value of this. So what will be the value? First change the sine waveform and change the value to 5 volt. Okay, let's change the value to 5 volt. After that, now again come into the probe and it is sine waveform and probe value is the 3.5, so it is reading 3.5 volt. Okay, probe is reading 3.5 volt, so it means the threshold value is 1.5. okay, 1.5 is the threshold value for 5. That's because when I was giving the value 1, so it was not showing any value. Okay, that's because it's not showing any value. Now stop, remove plotter, add plotter, run again. Now you can see the value. Okay, now stop. So you can take the components from this platform and you can connect and you can check. So let's take a diode. Sorry, let's take a not diode, take one LED. Where is the LED? Search. Okay, first take one fixed 5 volt. This one. Now come to the property, click the this 5 volt, so you can change the voltage from this platform. Okay, if we'll not select, not click, so, okay, so property with not will not visible. It will take the general property of this diagram. Okay, front scale 1.5 and others. So now keep this one is 5 by default. Now come into switch. Okay, this one is switch. Now connect like this. Now come here and take one LED. We need to search LED. There is the LED. Okay, now take this LED, click, connect like this. Come here and take one resistance. Take one resistance, connect resistance here. Now come here and take one ground, drag it. Okay, and ground. So after that, now run. Okay, now run this one. If it will off, so LED will glow. If it will off, so LED will glow. If it is on, sorry, on, the LED glow, off, so LED off. Okay. Now stop. Can we delete this one? Let's come here. Take the variable voltage source now and connect. Now run. Okay, now increase the value. Sorry, now increase the value. If you will increase the value, then LED will glow. Okay, so now you can change the fade of the LED. Okay, after 1 point, after, okay, after 2.5. so now come into the property, click on the LED. So what is the threshold value of LED? The threshold value of LED is 2.39999. that's round up 4. 2.4. okay, 2.3999. So let's change the threshold value of LED. The threshold value of LED is 1.50. threshold value of LED is 1.50. now click. So and change the color. Let's change the color yellow to green. Okay, now run. Now you can see the LED is glowing. Let's, if value will go to below 1.5, okay, run. Now if LED is below 1.5, sorry, the value is value of the voltage source is below 1.5, so LED is not glowing, not increase. Look at it, start. Okay, it's a start, it's glowing. Okay, so let's, you can connect other things like that. Good. So you can also change the you can also take other concepts and you can place here according to your requirement. There is the stepper motor, servo motors and other motors are present. Okay, so we'll see in the next video how can we use this stepper motor, servo motors and other motors according to our requirement in this video. Sorry. Okay, for that let's come. If you want to take Arduino, so you can take Arduino. If you want to give the ground, okay, if you want to take 5 volt, then you can take 5 volt from this platform. If you want to take ground, then this platform. So if you want to connect one LEDs, if you want to write a code for LED blinks, so how you can connect, so you need this. Okay, right now you need ground. If you want to write a code, this one is come to the ground. Okay, and if you want to only blink LED, so you can connect with the any kind of any digital value. Okay, any digital pin, this is a digital pin and a digital input output pin, and you can run, so it will work for you. But here no code, so it will not work. Okay, so here no code, that's why it stopped working. So now come again. So there is indicators and other things, so you can utilize according to your requirements. Okay, so thank you for watching this video. In the next video we'll see how can we what is the concept of Arduino programming. Okay, I am making this video for the summer internship program. If you want to join the summer internship program, which name is virtual automation based online summer internship program, so you can call me.